All right, we're going to go right into questions, so just raise your hand and fire away.
Not everybody at once. Well, this might be the shortest one we've had since I've been here.
Yeah.
Josh, you talk a lot about preparation every single week. Just how do you feel the preparation's been to this point? I know you still have 48 hours, but to this point, how do you feel about the preparation?
Yeah, the week's been really good. Guys have been focused, urgent in the way that they've entered the building, the meetings. Out in the practice field too. So, like what we've done up until now, the lead up to kickoff will be important as we finish our preparation.
Wes?
Josh, with the pace that y'all play at offensively, I mean, obviously, anytime you play on the road, there's going to be challenges involved with that. But because of the pace y'all go at and some of the signals and everything, is it maybe a little bit not as bad for y'all as it is for others?
We'll find out on game day. At the end of the day, there's been times since we've gotten here that we've handled, being on the road extremely well. There's other times where we haven't handled it. A lot of that's us. And, the communication and playing smart football will be important on Saturday, but anticipate us handling it well.
Mike?
Yeah, Coach, we heard Eric Ainge said that this crowd isn't any thing that Tennessee should worry about. Is there that big
bright shade of red you got behind it?
you played in a lot of stadiums like he was a quarterback. I mean, how different is it from one stadium to the next? And do you anticipate this place being any different than anywhere else you guys play?
Yeah, I anticipate being a great environment, big football game. They've been highly successful, and their fan base is excited for this one too. Ours is too. But it'll be a great environment. So anticipate crowd noise being a part of the football game for sure.
Tim? Coach, seeing that big smile on your face when you went on ESPN, you said you had found out just a couple minutes before. Did you at least take a few minutes to kind of step back and say, number one team in the country, this is pretty cool?
Did not move. I just been game planning and, for us, moved right back into it as soon as I was done with the show. I'm absolutely proud of what we've done up until this point, from the time we've gotten here until now. There's a lot of things that we continue to need to get better at. But the reality is that's the first show, first rankings. Everybody remembers what you do in November. The only one that matters is the last one. The reason we've gotten to the point where this is a big football game is because we've handled things the right way, coaches and players alike. Preparation, practice, and understanding, the type of football team. This is a really good football team, and they've been winning for a while, and great opportunity for us.
Wes?
Obviously, you've been complimentary of Danico Slaughter lately and the progress that he's made. When did he start to kind of step forward and emerge as a guy who you thought, okay, this guy's ready now to step in this league and make an impact?
I just think, he's constantly continued to push himself, and the early part of this season for sure had great confidence in him, and sometimes every opportunity that he wanted or we had planned on doesn't always come around in just the way the games unfold, but someone that inside of our building, our coaching staff has great trust in. He's physical, he's mature, he prepares. His best football is still out in front of him, which is exciting. Anticipating him playing well in this one too.
Vince?
Josh, your in-game coaching chemistry with the staff and making sure, because especially on offense, because you go so fast, how important is that to make sure you guys get the best of each moment?
Yeah, the communication, being able to adjust quickly within a drive or certainly after a drive and at halftime, it's a huge part of putting our kids in hopefully the best position to be successful. The amount of time that we spent together allows us to, draw back on past experiences, learning opportunities as we continue to grow and develop what we're doing.
That's true.
Could you talk about the Nico a little bit? Wesley Walker, another guy that played a little bit of safety over the past three games and played star two. Just his versatility, how much of an asset is that? And he's him being a first year guy. How much?
Talking about Wesley?
Yeah. How much of that curve has been him trying to learn?
Yeah, for sure. Someone, excuse me, that wasn't here in spring ball, you know, that started in June with us, you know, June and July, getting in shape and you know, getting used to the habits that we have inside of this building, then learning a defense, able to draw, certainly, you know, guys that have played college football, the verbiage might be different, there might be subtle tweaks in some of the coverages, but they have some experience to draw on that helps, you know, them in the learning process and has continued to heighten his understanding of what we're doing. He does have versatility. When we recruited him, we felt like he would have that type of versatility. And it's important, just as the season goes on, guys get dinged up, you know, being able to place guys in different spots. But excited about the way he's playing here, really all year long, but certainly in the last 3 or 4 weeks too.
Tim, the guy that can get after the quarterback, does that change anything for you guys at all going into this one?
Yeah, they don't just have one guy that can get after the quarterback. They're deep, and they have guys that can affect the quarterback. And, yeah, so it's next man up for them, and you know, for us, it doesn't really change the majority of what we're doing.
Josh, Jalen Wright's been pretty productive throughout the season. It seems like he's kind of taken this game to another level. This to a couple games recently. What's he doing better, and do you feel like he's done a better job of ball security and things like that after some of those early fumbling problems too?
Yeah, confidence, which stems from understanding, practice habits, doing little things at a really high level every day. You know, he was proud, excited. You know, we recognized him in the building, just, you know, his ball security last week, and some of the unique body positions that he got into that are tough to do that in. And he's still a young football player. You know, he's a year and a half into his college career. He's going to continue to get better at everything that the running back needs to do, but certainly playing with a great amount of confidence right now.
Anybody else? Mike, you got one?
Yeah. You faced Kirby when you were at Missouri as an OC, and now in terms of what they can do, right? In terms of what they can do, is pretty much it been run, and what are some of the intricacies within the game as far as the chess match that play out?
Say that one more time. The last part of the question I didn't hear. I'm sorry.
What are some of the intricacies that play out as far as the chess match with you having opposed him so many times already?
Yeah, everywhere you're at, the personnel is different, so your scheme's subtly different. Everybody continues to evolve in what they're able to do. The personnel that they have gives them a great amount of flexibility. I say that just because, you know, it's tough to find mismatches against them. They're deep, and you know, from pressures to coverage, rotations, all those things, it all is a part of how the game unfolds.
Finish with Ryan.
Josh, when you have a game with this kind of highest in the rankings and everything, obviously, do you reflect on your own experiences as a player and trying to help this team prepare for a game like this, or do you literally just try to treat it like it's the end of the game and not worry about that kind of stuff?
Yeah, I mean, I haven't really talked about my playing experiences this week with this football team. What I have talked about, like the outside noise and the fact that this is a big game, like everybody knows that, right? But the reality is like as a competitor, you're so entrenched in the preparation, or you should be, that you know, the week kind of unfolds in a normal routine for you. And our guys are confident. They prepared in a really good way, and you know, I don't feel like you know, they've changed their habits in any way that's going to hurt us during the course of the football game, you know what I mean, because we're not prepared. I think handling the emotion in the early stages of the football game is important in any big ball game. You know, you got to play extremely smart and settle into the football game early. I think that's important.
Thank you.
Thanks, guys.
Thanks, Seth.